I am David, your developer on duty. In this video, I will show you how to configure Vim Spectre. Okay, let's do this. I install my plugin called Vim Spectre and configure it. Here I just define some key mappings, for example, to launch and reset Vim Spectre, to step through the source code, and to toggle some breakpoints. Now let's source it and plug install the plugin. Now for this to work, you also need gadgets. So you can use the Vim Spectre command, Vim Spectre install, and then the name of your gadget, for example, VS Code Node Debug 2. Now, since this takes a while, I will not do this. Now in your project directory, you have to create a new file called .vimspectre.json. Here you can define all your adapters. In this case, I create an adapter called VS Code Node, which should be the default adapter. I don't want to pause on all exceptions. The configuration should be attached to node process. I want to skip all those node internal files, and the process ID should be $processID, which is a variable coming from outside. Using Vim Spectre is actually quite easy. For example, you can open some Express application and run it with a --inspect option. Then you can attach the debugger. For the process ID, you just hit enter, and now it's listening. You can now set some breakpoints, for example here. Now let's just trigger some HTTP request, and you can see the debugger pauses the execution flow. On the top left window, you have all your variables, for example, the request object. Below, you can enter any expression which you want to watch, for example, 1 plus 1 is 2. And below is the call stack, which you can also inspect and navigate. Now let's jump over, jump into, jump over. And you can see we can also watch the expression X, and currently the value is 9. Now, if we want to continue, we can do that. We can exit the debugger, remove all breakpoints, and we're done. Now let's add a little bit more advanced configuration. For example, here I define a mapping to call addToWatch, and addToWatch is a function which takes the current C expression under the cursor and adds it to the watch window of Vim Spectre. The other thing I do is to set the Vim Spectre base directory. This allows me to have only one configuration file for all my projects. And since we specified some global configuration, we have to edit. In this case, it has to be in the base directory, /configurations/, then the name of your operating system, in this case macOS, / then the name of your editor, you can also write __all/, and then some arbitrary name .json. And here we can paste the exact same adapter configuration which we defined previously. Now let's try it out. We delete the original vimspectre.json. We open our sample application. We launch it with the inspect configuration. We attach the debugger, and it works. Now we can also try this addToWatch function, and you can see also this works. Sometimes you also want to debug your tests. In this case, we need to configure our global configuration file and add a new adapter. This time we launch a node process with those runtime arguments. Keep in mind that since we use a global configuration file, we have no information about the project root. So here we use a global path to chest. We also use a variable called testName. This is a variable which we have to provide from outside when we call this adapter. Now we have to add a little bit more configuration. I define a function called chestStrategy, which takes a command generated by vimtest, from which I extract the test name using a regular expression, and then I call vimspectre-launch with settings, and I provide the test name. For vimtest, I define a custom strategy called chest, which is linked to that function, and then I bind leader.dd to run testNearest with a strategy chest. Let's see this in action. I fire up Vim and open some test file. And the first thing I want to do is to run all tests to see what's going on. and we can see that one test fails, 0 plus 1 is not 1, and we receive not a number instead. So let's see what's going on. I add a breakpoint and run the test with a debugger. I step into. Now here is the calculate function, so I step into, step over, step over. Now let's inspect those expressions. Constants.1 is 1, which seems correct, and number is undefined, which is wrong. Number comes from this method here, so let's go to the definition, and now we can see why it fails. This.x is 0, that means that this if statement will return false, and this method will return undefined instead of 0. So let's remove this if statement, let's rerun the test. Hit continue, and you can see the test passed. So let's stop the debugger and quit. Okay, it's done. I hope I could give you some information on how to configure Vim to be more like an IDE. Thanks for watching and stay tuned.